Before we start this video, check this shirt out. You like it? Well, you can get this on my official merchandise store. The link is in the description box. Now on to the video. If this doesn't show you that they hate us, I don't know what to tell you. AL Gravity, any day above ground, live it. So you already know what to do. Share, like, and subscribe. That's right, share, like, and subscribe, because I'm not like other YouTubers. I'm different. I want y'all to take a very, very hard look at the photo you see on the screen. The next person or people that tell you that nobody's going after black people and nobody hates us, and all we do when we talk about white supremacy is we're being pro-black woke people who want to sow dysfunction in a country that we should be lucky to live in. I want you to send them this picture and send them this story I'm about to read to you. These two black people, this married couple, got their child taken from them. They did home births. Shout out to Taisha Essex. She's a very big proponent of home births for black people, especially with how the hospital system treats black women. They decided to do a home birth. And because some cocksucking doctor did not like the fact that they didn't go to the hospital and the baby had jaundice, called 12 on them and got their child put into protective services. And the child is worse off now than when they were with their parents. But I'm finna read it so y'all can get the full gist of it. We're on WFAA. This is out of Dallas. North Texas parents demanding return of newborn taken by CPS over concerns about jaundice. Quote, "We've been treated like criminals, and that's far from the truth," Rodney Jackson said. "This is a nightmare I wouldn't wish on everyone. Guys, family, when I read this story, man, after I'm done, go hold your loved ones. Go hold your children. Because this story pissed me off. Boy... I'm going to save my comments for when I'm done. A husband and wife in DeSoto are demanding CPS return their newborn daughter after the days-old infant was taken from them in a dispute over the proper treatment for jaundice. The couple alleges CPS used the criminal history of the wrong mom to help justify taking the child. Yeah, we haven't heard that before. Mila Jackson was born on Tuesday, March 21st at the home of Rodney and Tamisha Jackson. A licensed midwife helped deliver the baby. At 6 pounds, 9 ounces, they say the child was healthy and the home birth successful. Shout out. 3 days later, the Jackson said they took the child to a pediatrician for a standard checkup and received a clean bill of health from the nurse practitioner. Sorry, I'm so mad right now. But later that day, Tamisha Jackson said she began receiving messages from Baylor Scott and white Dr. Anand Bhatt. I don't even know why they wrote that, but okay. The doctor said Mila had jaundice with dangerously high levels of bilirubin, which is a yellowish substance made during the body's normal process of breaking down old red blood cells. Mila's bilirubin level was 21.7. Dr. Bhatt wrote that at a beryllium. I'm sorry, folks. I just can't read this. I can't. Give me a second. Whoosah. All right. Dr. Bhatt wrote that at a bilirubin over 20, a baby risks brain damage because the bilirubin can cross the blood-brain barrier. Dr. Bhatt suggested the parents bring Mila to the hospital for phototherapy, a standard jaundice treatment. According to the Mayo Clinic, Infant jaundice usually occurs because a baby's liver isn't mature enough to get rid of bilirubin in the bloodstream. In some babies, an underlying disease may cause infant jaundice. The Jacksons say they told the doctor they would, with the help of their midwife, treat Miller's jaundice themselves at home, including the phototherapy treatment. Dr. Boss said he had concerns they would not have the correct lights, but the family also said they would supplement Tamisha's bread milk as recommended and provide Dr. Bot with the contact information for their licensed midwife, Cheryl Edinburgh. Several hours later into the night, Dr. Bot texts my phone very aggressive. Take her to the hospital or he's calling CPS, Tamisha Jackson said of the messages she received from the doctor. In his letter to CPS, Dr. Bot stated, I filed a case report with CPS after trying 10 attempts to appeal to the family through phone calls, text messages, and leaving voicemails as they did not pick up the phone. Parents are very loving and they care deeply about their baby, the doctor wrote. Their distrust for medical care and guidance has led them to make a decision for the baby to refuse a simple treatment that can prevent brain damage. I authorized the support of CPS to help get this baby the care that was medically necessary and needed, the letter continued. CPS agreed. In its own statement, it wrote, due to parents being unwilling to discuss the danger and potential consequences of this condition, it is necessary for the department to intervene. They discussed it with the doctor and they said, let us take care of it. And they would keep him informed. Why? Oh, my God. The CPS letter listed concerns of possible stroke, brain damage, or other immediate dangers to child. DeSoto police officers, armed with a court order, helped CPS take Miller from the home on March 28th. Unlawfully, they entered my home to take my baby from me, Tamisha Jackson said as she fought back tears at a Thursday, April 6th news conference held at the AFIA Center in Dallas. But the Jacksons and their legal team also point out an obvious problem with the affidavit filed with the court that allows CPS to take Miller. The affidavit used to justify CPS taking custody of the child lists the wrong mom, a woman with a completely different name and with a criminal history of child neglect. Fuck the cops. I'm just going to say that right out loud. Fuck them. This is no different when they sit up there and issue warrants and go into the wrong damn house. Fuck them. Tamisha Jackson, who has no criminal record, is not even listed as the child's mother on the affidavit. Instantly, I felt like they had stolen my baby as I had a home birth and they were trying to say my baby belonged to this other woman, Tamisha Jackson said. We've been treated like criminals, and that's far from the truth, Rodney Jackson said. This is a nightmare I wouldn't wish on anyone. Said Edinburgh, the midwife who helped deliver Miller, we are demanding that Miller be returned home today because yesterday was too late. A spokesman for CPS, unable to explain why a different woman with a criminal history is listed in the court documents, said the department could not comment on the case. Of course they can't. Of course they can't. State rules. Of course they can't. Baylor Scott and White sent WFAA a written statement. It reads as follows. In respect of patient privacy, it is inappropriate to provide comment on this matter. We do abide by reporting requirements set forth in the Texas Family Code and any other applicable laws. Meanwhile, Miller is being cared for by a foster family. The Jacksons, who were allowed to visit their daughter Wednesday at a CPS office, say they have been given a court date of April 20th.
I had to take a break because I found the Jezebel article they did where I originally saw this. The husband was out walking the dog. Mr. Jackson was out walking his dog. They told him to give the kid up. He said no. They put him under arrest, took his keys, and went in the house where the wife, the baby, and I think their other kids were in there. And they just took the baby. This is after they did what the doctor wanted. They told the midwife. The midwife gave the pediatrician all the information they wanted. And he still went through and got CPS and DeSoto police to take this kid away. These bastards came in these people's house at 4 a.m., do y'all understand the psychological trauma this family has gone through? They've had their kid taken.
They've had their home violated, not to mention what's going on with their other children waking up to hear yelling in the house. I don't even want to read this. I left it on the screen for a reason. Y'all can pause it and read it for yourself. Just read this part. Just read it.
I have had it. You done pushed me to a point. I don't care no more. I've had it.
Look at that picture. Look at that hurt. All you punk asses want to sit up there and knock each other all day, every day over some trivial shit. This right here is why we tell y'all to get on code. This is the exact reason. I'm not performing this, folks. I got a 3-year-old. Because some asshole got in his feelings because a black mother and a black father said, we gonna take care of our own. Damn what was going on with the history of black people in the medical system. We feel as though we can provide for this. We went to a black midwife and we sat there and we said, you know what? Let us handle this. This punk sat right there and wrote the state to go get this child taken away from a mother and father. I'm surprised the punk didn't sit up there and get all her kids taken, all his kids taken. This is why we tell you to get on code and stay on code. Because this shit can happen to you at any moment because somebody got in their feelings. Y'all hear that pitter-patter? That's my little one. I tell you this, somebody try this with me, that their lineage is done. I don't play with mine, just like my parents didn't play with theirs, just like their grandparents didn't play with theirs. That's the ultimate definition of being on code, making sure that evil don't show up at your doorstep. Evil visited them, and I don't know how the hell they're keeping it together. Shout out to them. Because I know that brother want to go do something. I know his old lady want to go sit up there and do something. But let me stop before I say something I'm going to regret. Let me stop here. But what I'm going to do, fam, is I'm going to upload the entire press conference on the channel. Well, I'm probably just going to do their part. I need y'all to watch and listen to what these people are saying. Okay, because this right here is ridiculous. And it should never have happened. And y'all saw me put the picture of the punk in the beginning. And he's also in the thumbnail. We need to go get his license revoked for this. Texas cannot get away with this. But anyway, y'all, let me get up out of here. You already know what to do. Share, like, and subscribe. That's right. Share, like, and subscribe, because I'm not like other YouTubers. I'm different. And also, happy New Black Media Appreciation Month, even though this ain't exactly the time to put this out there. But I would be remiss if I forgot to do it. But all y'all, take care. Stay safe. Hold your babies and protect your babies. And protect each other's babies. Protect each other's babies. I'm out.